As technology advances and space exploration becomes more feasible, the idea of mining asteroids for valuable resources is becoming more realistic. So how much you can earn by selling an asteroid? To know the answer, you have to stay until the end of this video. To start with, asteroids are remnants from the early solar system, left over from the formation of planets over 4.6 billion years ago. These rocky bodies orbit the Sun and can be found primarily in the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter, though they also exist throughout the solar system. Their sizes vary significantly, from small boulders to large celestial objects measuring hundreds of kilometers across. The total number of asteroids in the asteroid belt is hard to determine, but it's safe to say there are at least billions of them. And most of the asteroids are very small compared to other celestial bodies. In fact, a 1-kilometer-size asteroid is 20 times less common than a 100-meter-size asteroid. And majority of the asteroids in the solar system are just cannot be bigger than 20 meters in size. So to determine our asteroid for selling, it's safe to pick a 20 meters asteroid. So now we know the volume of the asteroid, but there is a second blank in the checklist. Asteroids are categorized based on their composition, size, and orbital characteristics. There are many types of asteroids, but the three primary types of asteroids are C-type, carbonaceous, S-type, silicaceous, and M-type, metallic. It is extremely crucial to have an idea on which type of asteroids you are targeting because each type has dramatically different properties and potential economic value. How dramatically? Well, you will see later. C-type asteroids are the most common type, making up about 75% of known asteroids. They are rich in carbon compounds and have a dark, non-reflective surface. These asteroids are believed to contain a variety of minerals, including clays, carbonates, and organic molecules. Their composition suggests that they hold valuable water and organic materials, which could be crucial for future space missions and as raw materials for life support systems. S-type asteroids account for around 17% of all known asteroids. They are composed mainly of silicate minerals and metal oxides. These asteroids are generally more reflective than C-types and contain a mix of iron, magnesium, and nickel. The presence of metals like iron and nickel makes S-type asteroids valuable for mining. They could provide essential metals for construction and manufacturing in space or on Earth. M-type asteroids make up about 8% of known asteroids. They are primarily composed of metallic elements such as iron and nickel, with some containing trace amounts of other metals. These asteroids are of significant interest due to their high metal content. They could potentially yield valuable metals such as platinum, gold, and rare earth elements, which are in high demand for various industrial applications. Each type of asteroid presents different opportunities and challenges for potential mining ventures. The value of an asteroid is largely determined by its composition and the market demand for the materials it contains. Understanding these types is crucial for assessing the potential earnings from asteroid mining. Luckily, it's easy to distinguish what type an asteroid belongs to. Just use your eyes. C-type are visually the darkest ones. Carbon, you know. S-type are the brightest ones. And M-type lies somewhere between them or close to S-type. To estimate the value of an asteroid, we need to consider its composition, size, and the market prices of the materials it contains. Here's a step-by-step approach to calculate the value of an asteroid. Based on the type of asteroid, C-type, S-type, or M-type, we can estimate the average concentration of valuable materials. For example, M-type asteroids are rich in metals, while C-type asteroids contain significant amounts of water and organic compounds. First of all, remember we were targeting 20 meters asteroids? We are dealing with the same size, but different mass. For a C-type asteroid, it would be like 6,000 tons on the scale. While if you are measuring an S-type asteroid, it would be more like 10,000 tons. The heaviest ones are M-type asteroid because they contain more metal, and they would be somewhere close to 15,000 tons. So just by identifying the type, you ended up getting completely different estimation in mass. But we are not entering the important part. Value. Once we know the asteroid's type, we can estimate the quantity of valuable materials it contains. As I mentioned before, C-type asteroids are the most common ones. Sounds great, but a common resource usually won't have much value. The C-type asteroids mainly consist of clay, minerals, and silicate rocks, with just a tiny bit of worthy metal. While the metal content in C-type asteroids can reach about 1% to 10% of their total mass, they are in very low concentrations, thus making them not useful at all. So you shouldn't consider a C-type asteroid. Then how about S-type asteroids? Juno and Eros are some classic examples of S-type asteroids. As you can see, they look brighter than those carbon C-type. They are stony but usually contain a healthy amount of iron and nickel, maybe aluminum and cobalt as well. These can make up 20% of the asteroid's mass. Look more closely, you may even find gold, platinum, and rhodium. Sounds not bad.
Calculation time.
For an S-type asteroid. Diameter, 20 meters. Estimated mass, 10,000 tons. Composition, 4% nickel, 16% iron. Market price of nickel, $16,000 per ton. Market price of iron, $100 per ton. Total nickel content, 400 tons. Total iron content, 1,600 tons. Value of nickel, 400 tons times $16,000 per ton equals $6,400,000. Value of iron, 1,600 tons times $100 per ton equals $160,000. Total value, $6.56 million. And about 100 kilograms of precious metal, which adds its value another 10% more. But what if you find an M-type asteroid? Like 16 Psyche. Those asteroids contain as much as 80% of their mass as iron, nickel, gold, and all sorts of precious metal. In fact, 16 Psyche is estimated at $100 quintillion in value. However, 16 Psyche is also 23 quintillion kg in weight. So if we scale it down to just 15,000 tons, the number goes down to $65 million. Which is 10 times more worthy than S-type asteroids. So be careful, even at the same size, an asteroid can sell you either 65 million or nothing. It all depends on which type. So, go catch bright asteroids. Of course, the potential earnings from asteroid mining must also account for the cost of extraction, processing, and transporting materials back to Earth or using them in space. These costs can be significant and affect the overall profitability of the venture. But that's not important in this video. Asteroids represent a fascinating and potentially lucrative frontier for future space exploration and resource extraction. The value of an asteroid varies widely based on its type, size, and composition. M-type asteroids, with their high metal content, offer the most immediate financial potential, while C-type and S-type asteroids also hold significant value in terms of water, organic compounds, and metals. As space technology advances and asteroid mining becomes more feasible, the financial prospects of selling an asteroid could become a reality. However, the costs associated with mining and transporting materials will play a crucial role in determining the overall profitability of such ventures. The concept of asteroid mining is still in its early stages, but the potential for earning substantial profits is evident. As technology progresses and the market for space resources develops, the dream of mining asteroids and reaping their economic benefits may become an integral part of our future space endeavors. But hey, what about stepping further? What can we find in the surrounding 20 light years? Well, watch this.